There are many models used to forecast the storm's track. Kimberly Speakman spoke with a UH meteorology professor who helped create a model that was spot on in tracking Hurricane Lane. Kimberly.
Marissa, what Professor Chen did was take the data from one well-known forecast model and add in environmental conditions similar to the hurricane. He says the model forecasted Lane's path exactly.
The most accurate forecast model for Hurricane Lane turned out to be the Global Forecast System, or GFS model. A professor and his PhD student took this model a step further and created their own with an adjustment. They changed the initial conditions for the model.
The initial condition we have is just let the model to spin up the vortex. Let the model to spin up tropical cyclones. We try techniques to make it close to the intensity that has been observed, and a structure that is very close.
The model is called Typhoon Initialization. It considers things like the hurricane's intensity. Professor Pao-Shin Chu says that determining the intensity of a hurricane is one of the hardest things to get a read on.
Hurricane intensity. Intensity is a difficult one because, you know, how do you know? By the time it reaches central North Pacific or even Hawaii Island, it will be tropical storm.
While the typhoon initialization model may not be used to determine the track of Hurricane Olivia, the National Weather Forecast says that all the forecast models are pretty close together.
Initially, over the next 3 or 4 days, there's very good agreement in the track forecast. By the time it gets this far west, there's more uncertainty that comes into play.
Because of the accuracy of Chen's model, it caught the eye of the Central Weather Bureau at Taipei. He says they are currently testing the model with their current one, and we may even see this model be put in use in next year's hurricane season. Marissa.